Hello.
Oh, hi. Is this the chat line?
That's right, my love.
The pre-COVID chat line.
Yes. Why don't you tell me your fantasy? Your pre-COVID fantasy.
I'm not sure I can.
Don't be embarrassed, darling. I've heard it all before.
Okay, well, I suppose I'd love to go to the pub with my mates.
You open the door. And it's heaving. You haven't even booked a table, so you have to stand at the bar.
Keep talking.
You rip open a packet of salt and vinegar Walkers and you share them with a group of friends. And you can't even remember the last time you washed your hands.
Oh, this is good.
And people are singing karaoke in the corner and they're having so much fun. And you don't even notice how much spit is getting on the microphone.
What are we wearing?
No one's wearing a mask. It would be considered weird to wear a mask.
Oh God, don't stop.
And the football's on in the corner, and your favorite team's just scored, and you all stand up, and you're all hugging each other because you're so happy.
Yes.
Hello? Hello? Yes, sir, you're still the president. Hello, pre-COVID chat line. Tell me your pre-COVID fantasy.
I just really want to go bowling, then watch a film at a retail park next to a ring road.
At the bowling alley, you order nachos.
Oh, yes.
You lick your fingers before plunging them into the holes of the bowl. You aim at the pins and lick your fingers again. You haven't washed your hands since before you left the house.
So unhygienic.
When you get to the cinema, the trailers have already started.
They're the best bit.
You have to clamber over people to get to your seat. No one lets you pass. You accidentally touch someone's
I
crotch.
just want to touch somebody.
A group of teenagers are laughing and throwing popcorn behind you. And you imagine yourself standing up and confronting them, becoming the hero of the whole audience. And you actually do.
Nothing.
When you get up to leave, you realize your phone has slipped down the back of the chair. And you slide your hand through the hinge to retrieve it. You also find a pound coin. It's so sticky.
Oh, God.
As you drive off, it starts to rain. And you see the teenagers from the cinema standing at the bus stop.
Oh, God.
And they are completely drenched.
Oh, God.
Hello? Hello, pre-COVID chat line. Tell me your pre-COVID fantasy.
This might sound a bit weird, but
Nothing's weird to me, darling.
I really miss going on a disappointing package holiday somewhere hot.
You arrive at Stansted Airport far too early in the morning. You're still at the back of the queue.
Classic.
You didn't pay an extra fee, so you're in a middle seat on the plane.
Who am I next to?
A man's eating a hot Cornish pasty on one side, and a woman's painting her nails on the other.
So many smells.
Your flight's delayed.
Oh, God.
So by the time you arrive at your hotel, the only food available is a packet of foreign crisps from the minibar. And they're astonishingly expensive.
And weirdly cold and soft.
The hotel is next to a building site. There are towels on every lounger.
So frustrating.
The breakfast buffet is completely uncovered.
So awful.
All of the serving spoons have been in the paella. Somehow there is ham in everything.
Oh, God.
And the evening entertainment is a Barry White impersonator.
Okay.
Who is white?
So inappropriate.
As you're about to fall asleep, You notice a cockroach on the wall.
Keep going.
And you spend the whole week composing your TripAdvisor review in your head.
One star.
Hello. Mummy's just going to be a second in the bathroom, okay? Darling, can you take, you know... All right. I'm just going to be a second.
Hello, pre-COVID chat line. Tell me your pre-COVID fantasy.
I just wish I could have some time to myself.
You head off on a weekend away.
Full weekend away sounds unrealistic.
You check into a spa day.
Still feels like too much. I mean, just a few hours would be nice.
Right, okay. How about... Your husband is at the office.
Oh God, yes.
Your kids are at their grandparents'. They're not going to accidentally infect them with a virus.
Well, that would be lovely.
You go to a local cafe for a cup of tea and a cake. You pay in cash.
Oh, I miss coins.
You bump into a friend in the street and have a 5-minute conversation that doesn't include the words virus, vaccine, social distancing, bubble, or Zoom.
Keep going.
You get your nails done. You don't have to wear a mask.
But they still do.
They still do. You go home and have a long bath.
But my nails?
They're shellac.
Oh God, yes.
You curl up on the sofa with a glass of wine and your favourite TV show. No one else is anywhere near the remote.
Keep going.
Your husband texts to say he's going to be back late and the kids are having a sleepover.
Don't stop.
You have the whole house to yourself.
Oh, yes.
For the whole evening.
Okay, I'm coming!
Hello?
One of our favourite viral things which we've done, which we haven't done, but someone's done this year, is a comedian, Matt Green. And it was the pre-COVID hotline. Did you see this? It's a chat line that lets you live out all your pre-COVID fantasies.
This is an amazing idea, isn't it? Because think about it, all those things that you used to just be able to do, the kind of things you just take for granted, now they're the same things that you would just do anything to be able to do again.
So it's run by two comedians, Matt and Natasha Green, and it's basically like a little sexy phone line where you can live out your pre-COVID fantasies. Matt has made other pre-COVID chatline videos as well. You can find them on his Twitter, at Matt Green Comedy. But... they're ready and waiting, so I think we should give it a go now. So I'll go first, okay?
Okay.
So I'm going to call the pre-COVID chat line and tell them what I would like.
Hello, pre-COVID chat line. Tell me your pre-COVID fantasy.
Hello. I really want to be at a music festival.
You arrive and park your car in a muddy field. You immediately forget where it is.
Standard.
You smugly put your tent up in the VIP area. Then you notice that someone else has brought a camper van. It's Nick Grimshaw.
Yeah, it's always Nick Grimshaw.
You queue for ages at the bar to buy a very expensive beer in a flimsy plastic glass. It's slightly warm.
Yeah.
You push yourself through the crowd. All you can smell is sweat and mud and other things you can't mention on the radio. Your face is near someone's armpit at all times.
Oh, God, yes, please.
And the band starts playing your favourite song. The crowd goes wild.
Yes.
Pints of beer are being thrown into the air all around you. At least you hope it's beer.
Oh, it's so wet.
Suddenly, you need to go to the toilet. You wonder if there will be antibacterial gel. You definitely don't have your own.
I don't even care.
You smell the portaloos before you see them. The queues snake away into the distance. You've mistimed this.
Oh, God.
You look at the nearly empty pint glass in your hand and think
about... No, that's enough! I really enjoyed that. Yeah.